Hello guys. Good afternoon. Am I audible? Can you please confirm me? Okay, thank you all for your confirmation. So today, what we need to do, we need to do the implementation of supervised machine learning, and one type is linear regression. Okay. I'm just waiting for 2 3 minutes. Till now, if you have any question, you can ask me. Meanwhile, I'll check your answers. Today I got some answers. Earth is written answer of circularly identical, and one is Kanika also from this batch, I think. Kanika present. Hello, Kanika, are you there? Am I audible to all of you? Hello, guys. Okay. Okay, actually, yesterday we faced the problem. That's why I'm asking again and again. Okay. Who is this? EM Flex. No, Aarti, your answer is not correct actually. It's not about the equal of two list. It's basically circularly identical. Means when we are sifting a list like this one, list 1, 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Then you started 50, this. Where is the 20? You moved the 20 also. These are the not identical actually. No, this is not the correct answer. And somebody else written from this batch is only the Kanika is also written. These are the from other batch. Kanika is taken list 1, list 2, and list 3. this. Less one and less two are they circularly identical, and others are not. If circularly identical, yes. See, is it, what is the logic behind? Okay, this is the function say return. Think C is not present. Okay, I'll comment over that. No issue. Okay, guys, and what about the other question? Have you tried the problem two or problem one? Manish and Matre. Kanika also tried this one. Okay, I'll check after the class and I'll write the comment below that. Okay? Yeah, yours is right, Kanika. For the circularly identical, I think yours right. And this is, I have not checked yet, so I'll check it. So guys, today what we need to implement, we need to implement the machine learning algorithm. Okay? And in the machine learning algorithm, what you need to do first, like you know the process, in the machine learning process is first you need to take some data set. After that, you need to divide the data set into two parts. One is the training part and another one is testing part, right? So what we need to do here, actually we have one new library that is called the sklearn. Okay, sklearn in Python is a library that is the mainly designed for the machine learning to implement the machine learning algorithms. You can see the official documentation of sklearn. It is a library that is specially designed for the implementation of machine learning algorithms. There are lots of algorithms already inbuilt inside this library, like machine learning in Python. Like there is a one algorithm called regression, another one is classification, clustering. All the there are certain functions available inside the sklearn to implement the different algorithms. Okay, so basically this is the library, and second thing is this library also have some standard data sets, sklearn data sets. If you search over this, then you will find like there are lots of data sets available. Like Boston, Iris, diabetes, digits. What are these actually? Actually, when you want to implement any algorithm, you need some standardized data set. Basically, a data set in a particular format. So, for that, you need to standardize your data, and it won't possible like you will make your data set and you will standardize that data. That is very difficulty in the initial stage when you are trying to implement the machine learning and when you are trying to learn this machine learning, that time you need some standard data set. And basically it provides some standard data sets. We can use those data sets and we can try our algorithms. Okay. So sklearn have some algorithms, it have some standard data sets, and it also have some performance measures. You can say them sklearn matrices. Like in the matrices, you can calculate, you have different different methods to measure the performance of a particular algorithm. For that, we have R2 square, we have mean square error, different accuracy, all these things we need to evaluate a algorithm. So basically, I think you got it. It have three things mainly. It have lots of more things also, but mainly we use three things from the sklearn. One is the algorithms, another one is data sets, and the third one is performance measures. Okay. So first to implementation, what I will do, I will just import some important libraries, and you can see here in the machine learning course content. Like here, you can see the implementation. We implemented one algorithm, one problem that is called the Boston housing price problem with regression. What is actually problem? Predicting Boston house price with regression. Actually, this problem is we have some data set, like we predicts the price of houses in Boston. Boston is a city in which we need to predict the price of houses using a machine learning algorithm called linear regression. I think you are a little bit aware with the linear regression now, because yesterday we have done this part. And to train our machine learning model, we will be using Escalon's Boston data set. So basically, for this purpose, what we will be going to use, we will be use Boston housing price data set. Okay, so first thing, what we need to do, we need to import certain libraries that will be used. Like first is pandas, we need matplotlib for plotting the graph, we need NumPy, we will need it on sklearn, and inside the sklearn we will require the linear underscore models and data sets and matrices. So first thing, what you need to do, you need to just implement, you need to just import these libraries. I'm just going to open my Jupyter notebook. Okay. Just a second. Simply just open your Anaconda Navigator and then launch the Jupyter Notebook, right? Here I have different environments, that's why I have selected one. By default, you have only the base environment, so you do not need to select anything. Simply just open it. Okay. I'll just one new file. I'll just open one new file. And here, what I will do, I'll just import all the libraries. From here, I'm taking the code. I don't need underscore. Certain terms you already know, and some terms are new for you. We will learn them when it will come to that point. So basically, simple, we have imported the library. Now, what I will do, I will just load this data set. Like, I just want to check what is this data set. So first, I just need to import this data set, need to keep this data set into a single variable, and then I'll see what is inside it and how I will analyze this data using linear regression. How I will train a algorithm, how I will create a predictor or a model, right? So simply Boston is equal to load underscore Boston. Simply I'm loading the data, and now I'm going to print Boston. Here you can see I got the some things, like first the curly braces. You can see this curly braces, and then I have one variable called the data, right? and then colon, and then the some values inside an array, right? So this is kind of a dictionary. I have a key, then colon, and then a value inside an array, right? And simply when I go slowly down, I'll show you. And the second key here you can see is the target, and it have the values inside the array. Okay, and simply there are the lots of keys and values available inside this curly braces, and it is closing at the end this curly brace, right? So basically we have one key is called the data, another key is one key is called data, another key is called the target, and then the next key you can see the feature underscore names, and then the next key you can see the description, and then the next key you can see some file name, right? Or either you can check that using this function you already know, like Boston is a dictionary. You can see it is a kind of dictionary. Basically it is a SQL and utils, and it is basically a kind of dictionary. So we can use the dictionary functions sklearn.keys. Simply, you know, dictionary.keys is a function that provide you all the keys name, right? Here you can see we have different keys. One is the data, another one is the target, and then the feature name, and then the description, right? So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. There should be one more that is called the file name. Why it is not getting? Maybe it is older version. My Jupyter notebook have older version, and the SQLearn is not updated. That's why it's taking only the 4 keys. You can see there would be one more that is called the file name, right? Now you can see we have different keys. Now we can check the what the values inside each key, right? Initially, what I am going to do here, what is my purpose? I'm just loaded the data set, that is the load underscore Boston. Basically, first I'm checking what is inside this data. How can I use this data for my machine learning algorithm, linear regression? So first I need to understand the data only. Then can I, after that only, I can implement the linear regression. Okay. In my Jaya is written in my internet, my end internet issue. I can only listen your voice. So please let me know which topic we are doing. Actually, Jaya, we are doing the implementation of Boston housing price, like this one. You can see this is the, just a second, 4, 4, 8, 9. 10th topic in machine learning module. Okay, you can open this topic, right? And I got another question. I think the ma'am last code not copied properly. Priya written. No, Priya, it is not issue of the code. Okay. And Boston library is already have these data. So Priyansa is written. Actually, Boston is not a library. Load underscore Boston is a data set basically. Okay. They have a stored data set in the form of a dictionary kind of. or escalon utils, you can say, actually. Okay, Supriyanshi. So basically, what I am doing here, I just imported all the libraries and then I have like loaded the data inside this load underscore Boston. Okay, and now my data is inside the Boston variable. Boston is equal to load underscore Boston, and now my data inside the Boston, and you can see Boston is a kind of library, a kind of dictionary. So I can access all the keys, all the values using the keys. So I have just checked what the keys available basically. So available keys are boston.keys, and it have provided a list of all the keys, right? Now what I will do, I will check value at every key, right? Boston dot data. I can access the dictionary like this, or I can write similar thing like Boston in the brackets data. Both are the same thing. Generally, we can use this one also, and we can use this one also. Okay. Dictionary name dot key, or either dictionary name in the square bracket single quotes, we can write the key. Okay, so just boston.data, you can see what inside the boston.data. Inside the boston.data, there is an array that have different values. Okay, like this is the list of list. This is the first list, then second list, then third list. How can I check what are the all data? Actually, I can say check the shape of this dictionary, dictionary key, boston.data and dot shape. I already know this function. So this is showing me boston.data.shape have 506 rows and 13 columns, right? Now I have 506 rows and 13 columns, okay? And simply you can see, read the description about the load underscore Boston, what actually this data. So I can check Boston dot DESCR. This is one of the key. Boston dot DESCR will show you the description of the Boston data set. And here you can see this is a data set. Boston housing price is a data set characteristics like number of instances 506. We have 506 rows and number of attributes 13, right? So here you can see, and then the median value, and then the attribute information, like what are the attributes actually? One is the crime rate, one is equal to ZN, ID, NUS, all these parameters we have. Basically, you can say we have 506 rows and 13 columns, and all 13 columns are the features, right? Okay. So one thing I have checked the data and the description. Next thing I'll check Boston dot feature underscore names, right? Here you can see these are the names of the feature. Basically, I can say these are the name of the columns. It is, I can say these are the column headings. Basically, first column having CRIM, second is ZN, INDUS. All these are the headings of the columns. So basically we have data set in which we have 13 columns. So these are the headings of the column, and you can see the description inside this description. Okay, so one thing I have checked is data, another is feature names, and another one is description. Now what left is target. So basically Boston dot target is having an array. I didn't get what is this. So what I will do, I will check the shape of this target. So Boston dot target dot shape. Okay, So it is showing me it have 506 rows. So there is only one column, it have 506 rows only. So you can understand from here, we have 506 rows of 13 features, and then the target is a one single column that have the 506 rows. You are getting my point? Basically, we have 13 features and one output that is inside the target. So what we need to do now, we will make equation of linear regression, that is the equation called the line. In the line equation, what we have, one y and one x. X we can call as a independent variable. These are the R features. Our 13 features are independent to each other. Okay, and then what we will generate, we will generate the price of the Boston house. We will predict the price of the Boston house. That will be our target, right? So basically, हमारे पास क्या है? 506 rows हैं, उनमें से 13 columns हैं. ये 13 columns हमारे features हैं, and then हमारा output जो होगा, वो Boston dot target के अंदर है. Output का एक ही column है, 506 rows है. And description में आप पढ़ सकते हो उस data set के बारे में. And simply आप Google पे भी पढ़ सकते हो. जब मैंने sklearn.datasets किया था, like sklearn.datasets, like here is the load underscore Boston, Boston housing price data set, and what are the characteristics of this data set? Basically, number of instances 506, number of attributes 13, these are the features, and then you can see the information about the attribute. What are all these 13 columns? So this is the description about these, and then the missing value is none, right? So this is basically about the data, and we have also checked each and every column, right? So now what I will do, I'll make a line equation. So I need some x, I need some y, right? So here x is my Boston dot data, okay, and y is my Boston dot target. So I'll make whenever I have some Excel format, data in Excel format, it basically have some x and like some features and then one output column. So similarly, I need to make here, right? This one I have done, I have checked this. And here what I will do, I will basically convert this dictionary into the data frame. Why? Because data frame I can easily check each and every label. So I'll print this, I'll convert this to the data frame. For the data frame, what I need to do, I need to pass a dictionary into the pd.dataframe function. Like simple function pd.dataframe, boston.data will be stored now into the BOS, right? So BOS will contain the data frame of data. And here I can see, I can check some rows from BOS. What is the actually BOS? You can see it is two rows and 13 columns. Columns started from 0 to 12. Okay, guys, now you are getting the things. Just send me a quick confirmation so that I'll ensure like you are getting the things, because this is very important, guys. And this is the important topic. If you understand this topic, then it would be very easy for you guys to implement any machine learning algorithm, because the process always is, it follows the same process. Like first we need to see our data, data sets, and then we need to divide the data set into two parts, and then we implement some algorithm. So Priyanshi, what you want, repeat this conversion, ma'am. Okay, this is simply, I have data, like we have checked Boston dot data. Simply Boston dot data, you can see it is a dictionary kind of values inside a key, a Boston is a dictionary, and we have a key called data, and there is the values residing at the place of data is boston.data. So simply we are converting this to a data frame. Why we are converting a data frame? Because data frame is very easy to handle, and we have lots of functions also available. We can check it very easily. So we have converted pd.data frame in this, and now my data will be stored into the boss, and simply I'm checking the head two means top two rows, what is inside the boss. Got it? Simply मैं ये देख रही हूँ कि मेरा क्या क्या चीजें हैं. Boss is again one another variable. It is simple variable I have defined. You can give any name, whatever you want. Okay. Now what I will do, I'll write here. Here you can see labeling of the columns are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 12, and labeling of rows are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 like 5 till 506. So what I need to here, I need to write the names of the column, because I have name of the columns inside the boston.feature names. So I'll store them like boss. Boss.columns is equal to boston.feature_names, right? And you can print now you can see we have one more thing. Here we have simple data frame. Now we have the labeled columns, like we have column names, right? So simply what we have done, we know already boston.feature names having the column headings, and we are saving that values inside the boss.columns. Now we have a data frame that is called the boss. Okay. Now we need to make x and y. So basically, x is equal to boss, and y is equal to boston dot target, right? Tanya, please copy with me. It is not, I cannot repeat the things. Actually, simply what I am doing here, I'm just putting the column names, feature names inside the boss.column names, because boss.column names is basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 till 12. What we need the names of the columns here, and names of columns we know. The feature names is inside boston.feature names. We will put it into the boss.columns. Now you can print the boss.head. It will give you the prototype two top records with the column headings. Okay. So simply we have done till this. Okay. Now adding the feature names to the data frame, we have done this part also. Here you can see there some, it is provided with some descriptions. Feature descriptions, you already know, I told you. You can see from boston.d description, right? Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add one more column to the boston. Like to the boss. Like our boss, you can check the shape of the boss, like boss dot shape 506,13. Now, like जब आप लोगों के पास कोई डेटा होता है, एक एक्सेल में डेटा है, तो आपके पास क्या होता है? बेसिकली आपके पास कुछ फीचर्स होते हैं एंड फिर कुछ वाई, कुछ प्रेडिक्शन वाली वैल्यू होती है. यहाँ पे हमारे पास बॉस में केवल एंड केवल फीचर्स हैं. सो व्हाट वी विल डू हियर, वी विल ऐड द y prediction. Okay, so how to add a column in the pandas? Basically, to add a column in the pandas, you need to write boss in the single quotes, in the bracket single quotes, just write the name of the field, like price is equal to Boston dot target. Okay, the data inside the Boston dot target would be added to a column called price. Here the next column will be added, that is after the L state, that would be price, and the values inside the price would be Boston dot target. Okay, so this is the simple crime gen, and these are the columns features, and this price is output. Okay, now your data is prepared. You need to divide it into two parts. One is X and another one is Y, and then we will divide X, Y into test and train. So we can say our Y is equal to Bosch price print Y. You can see this is a single column, right? And simply what next I'll do here, I'll just take X is equal to Boss dot drop and you can print X. What happened? Boss dot drop. Drop is a function, so I need to write this. Okay, and simply I need to mention like the complete rows, all the rows should be eliminated. X is equal to 1. Y dot head 3. You can see Y have one single column, that is the values inside the price, and then X dropped the price. Other than the price, all the columns came into the X. Okay, so simply we have dropped the price column. Here what I have added and why I have added draw price and drop, because I was just telling you how to add columns in the data frame. Okay, so just I have added, and after that I have dropped this X divided into X and Y. Now you have your data set in the form of XY. So simply what you need to do, you need to convert the X into two part, X train and X test, and similarly Y into two part, X test and X train, right? And it should be corresponding. So we have one function inside the sklearn, sklearn dot dataset dot split, like this function we have. Till now, till this we know. Okay, here you can see the price column is dropped out. Split train and test data. What we will do now, split train and test data. So we have a function available inside the sklearn that is called the train underscore test underscore split, but it is inside the model underscore selection. You can see from here, like split train and taste. Okay. And simply what we are going to do here. We are going to import a function that is the sklearn. Inside the sklearn, we have model underscore selection, and then we have train underscore taste underscore split. This is a function, and inside this function, what we need to pass? We need to pass x and y, and the amount of data that we want to separate for the testing and training. So simply inside the bracket, I have written x, then written the capital Y, and then you can see written the taste underscore size. These are the standard parameters. Is equal to value, you can change, like here we have taken 0.33, like it would be the 33% data is for the testing and remaining data for the training. And one more parameter we have added here is equal to random underscore num state. Basically guys, humne yahan pe ek naya parameter liya hai, random underscore state. रैंडम अंडरस्कोर स्टेट क्या होता है हमारा, ये जैसे आप इस डेटा को स्प्लिट किया आपने, तो फर्स्ट टाइम क्या हुआ, आपके पास 506 रिकॉर्ड्स हैं, 506 रिकॉर्ड्स में से 33% टेस्टिंग में चला गया बोथ एक्स एंड वाई, एंड 33 रिमेनिंग 67% डेटा हमारा ट्रेनिंग में चला गया. बट इसी कोड को मैं दूसरी बार एग्जीक्यूट करूंगी तो सेम थिंग इट विल हैपन, दैट 33% टेस्टिंग के लिए जाएगा और 67% ट्रेनिंग के लिए जाएगा. बट इट विल, इट कैन टेक द डिफरेंट लाइक 67%, लाइक इन द फर्स्ट टाइम इट हैव टेकन द रिकॉर्ड्स फ्रॉम द टोटल 506 रिकॉर्ड्स, द डिफरेंट रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ द 67%, एंड नेक्स्ट टाइम इट हैव एलिमिनेटेड सम डेटा फ्रॉम द ट्रेन एंड इंक्लूडेड सम डेटा फ्रॉम द टेस्ट. लाइक आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू से यू, इट कैन चेंज इट्स ग्रुप. Like first time mein from 506 is it have taken 400 as a training, and the remaining 106 would be for the testing. Next time also it will divide into the same portion, but data can be different. Like the 67% jo data tha jo pehle liya tha, वही सेम डेटा ना ले, हम दूसरा डेटा सेट भी उठा, उसी डेटा सेट में से दूसरी रोज भी हम ले सकते हैं. बट हमें क्या चाहिए, हमें वो कि वो सेम रोज चाहिए. लाइक आपने फर्स्ट टाइम जो रोज लिए हैं वही आप अगली बार लेंगे, उसके लिए आप यहाँ पे लिखते हैं रैंडम अंडरस्कोर स्टैट इज इक्वल टू 5 एनी नंबर. ओके, सो आई गॉट एन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सिद्धार्थ. But why we are doing this with the 33% data only? We are not doing with the 33%. We are dividing total 100% data, and the 33% data would be testing and 67% data would be training. Got it, Parab? We divided data into two parts. One is the training, another one is testing. Why we have divided? From the training, model will learn. And from the remaining testing data, we will test after the training, model training. Or we can say we can cross check the validation, cross validation. Basically, हम लोगों को, हमने जो मॉडल बनाया उसमें हमने 67% डेटा से उसको ट्रेन किया. अब हमको चेक करना है कि वो हमारा मॉडल कितनी मतलब कि कितना एक्यूरेसी दे रहा है. तो हमने उसी में से कुछ 33% डेटा ऐसा रख लिया जो हमने ट्रेनिंग के टाइम उसको नहीं दिया. लाइक आप छोटे बच्चे की बात करते हैं, आपने उसको 10 फ्रूट्स दिए हैं, 10 फ्रूट्स में दो तरह के फ्रूट है, पांच एक टाइप के, पांच एक टाइप के. आपने उसको दिए, उसने लर्न कर लिया कि एप्पल और मैंगो. उसके बाद उन 10 के अलावा आपके पास पांच और फ्रूट्स हैं, उनमें से दो मैंगो हैं, तीन एप्पल हैं. तो आप उसको मैंगो ले जाओगे तो वो आपको बताएगा कि ये मैंगो है, और एप्पल ले जाओगे तो वो बताएगा एप्पल है. अगर वो करेक्ट बता रहा है तो उसकी एक्यूरेसी हम चेक करेंगे कितने परसेंट तक करेक्ट बता रहा है. यही चीज अगर आपके पास वो फ्रूट्स टेस्टिंग के लिए है ही नहीं तो आप कैसे टेस्टिंग करेंगे. सो बेसिकली हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, हम लोग उस डेटा को, टोटल डेटा को दो पार्ट में डिवाइड कर रहे हैं, एक ट्रेनिंग और एक टेस्टिंग. Okay, Param got it? Nicholas written, what percentage ratio will be the best for the max efficiency? It's up to the data set. Generally, we prefer the 70-30, or sometimes we prefer the 80-20 also. No, Resh, same question is Marin Moy is asking, in which ratio training and testing data set should be divided? It is up to you. Like, after the experience, you will get the things. Like, when sometimes you'll check the model with the 70%, sometimes you check the model with 75%, sometimes you will check the model with the 80%. Okay? But it won't take, like, itna zyada data, hum log at least 20% data to minimum remaining rakhte hain testing ke liye. Sare data se hum train nahi karate. Otherwise, kya ho jata? Overfitting ho jati. Overfitting ek case hota hai jisme aapne usko sab kuch learn kara diya. उस केस में वो जो चीजें उसने लर्न की हैं उसमें से तो प्रेडिक्शन अच्छा करेगा, बट आप कोई नया पैटर्न लाएंगे तो वो प्रेडिक्शन नहीं करेगा, तो ओवरफिटिंग भी नहीं कराते हैं. ओके, गॉट इट. नाउ हियर आई एम डूइंग दिस. We have divided data into, and simply here we have taken x and y. The order should be like x, first divide x into two part, and first thing would be the always train. So I have taken the variable name x underscore train, and the second variable is x underscore test. So it is the two part of x, like x train and x test, and corresponding y train and y test. And first variable should be always x, and then these two variables should be always x train and x test. Like variables ke naam aap change kar sakte hain, but meaning yahi hoga ki jo pehle variable mein data jayega wo always x train ka hoga, uske baad x test ka hoga, uske baad y train and y test. Okay guys. We have divided the data. Now you can check the data shapes. Like you can check the shape of x train, x test, y train, y test. X underscore train dot shape. X underscore test dot shape. Okay, I'll passing inside the print function. You can see we have training data 339 and we have testing data 167. Both have the 13 columns. Okay. And similarly, you can test for the print y. Y should be have the same shape, like y underscore train print y underscore test. Sorry, shape I need to print now. So you can see why have only one column. That's why it's showing 339 rows. Like training data, both the training data have the same rows. Okay, and both the testing data have the same rows. Columns is different because X have 13 columns and Y have only one column. I think now it is clear. And here you can read the explanation also provided. Okay. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to implement the model. Okay. Are you getting, guys? Till this step, our data part is complete. We have parted the data into two parts. Okay. And we have divided data into X and Y. Now we are going to implement this linear regression. So simply, I'm going upper side. Like here from the linear model, I have just imported linear regression. Okay, so I just want to implement this linear regression. LM a variable, आप कोई भी नाम दे सकते हो. LM is equal to linear regression. अब मेरा linear regression की जो भी equation होती है वो LM में आ गई. Actually this is the inbuilt function. एक तरह से ये predefined function है. Linear regression का function implement हो जाएगा इसमें. SK11 के अंदर linear regression predefined है. तो ये मेरा किस में आ गया? LM variable में हमने store कर लिया इसको. LM is equal to linear regression. Okay? Now next what I am doing here, lm.fit. अब मैं मॉडल को क्या करा रही हूँ? ट्रेनिंग. ट्रेनिंग कराने के लिए हमारे पास यहाँ पे फंक्शन होता है fit. So fit means I am training the model. What is the model name? lm. lm जिसमें मेरी इक्वेशन है, इक्वेशन कह सकती हूँ मैं, मॉडल कह सकती हूँ. So basically जनरल वर्ड हम जो यूज करते हैं वो मॉडल यूज करते हैं. So मेरा मॉडल किस वेरिएबल में? lm में. एंड एल एम में अब मैं डेटा की ट्रेनिंग करा रही हूँ. ट्रेनिंग किससे करानी है? एक्स ट्रेन और वाई ट्रेन डेटा से. मेरे पास चार पार्ट हैं डेटा के. एक्स ट्रेन और वाई ट्रेन मेरे को इसमें चाहिए, जिससे मैं उसको बताऊंगी एक्स ट्रेन के जो फीचर है उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग वाई ट्रेन उसका आउटपुट है. राइट सो इस तरह से एक्स ट्रेन मेरे पास कितना है? 339 और 13 कॉलम्स. और सिमिलरली वाई ट्रेन मेरे पास कितना है? 339 यानी कि 339 रोज और 1 कॉलम. ओके सो सिंपली आई हैव इंपोर्टेड द मॉडल LM इज इक्वल टू लीनियर रिग्रेशन. लीनियर रिग्रेशन अब मेरा LM में आ गया. LM डॉट फिट. फिट इज ए फंक्शन दैट ट्रेन द मॉडल. ओके एंड आप इनके डिस्क्रिप्शन और अच्छे से पढ़ सकते हैं इसके लर्न पे. LM डॉट फिट. फिट के अंदर मुझे क्या पास कराना है? एक्स ट्रेन और वाई ट्रेन. इस x के करस्पॉन्डिंग y ट्रेन ये है. ओके सो हमारे पास डेटा है वो दो पार्ट में है, उसमें से हमने उसको लर्निंग करा दी. नाउ यू कैन रन इट एंड सिंपली LM में मेरा मॉडल प्रिपेयर हो जाएगा. अब मैं LM को आगे यूज कर सकती. I'm saving some time, that's why I'm copying the things. So it would be easy for me. Basically, अब मैं क्या कर रही हूँ? LM model मेरा बन चुका है, ठीक है? अब मुझे LM model से prediction करना है. Prediction क्या करेंगे हम? रुको, I'm commenting this one. Basically, I have model LM, और for the prediction, I have predict function. Inside the predict function, I need to pass x values. And then it will give you the output of y values, right? So here what I have passed x underscore train. X underscore train, as I already know, x underscore train. जब मैं pass करती हूँ x underscore train जब होता है तो उसके corresponding output क्या होता है? Y underscore train. ठीक है? x ट्रेन के करस्पॉन्डिंग आउटपुट क्या होता है? y अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन एक्चुअल आउटपुट हमें पता है. लेकिन हम lm डॉट प्रिडिक्ट के अंदर x अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन डालते हैं तो ये हमें कुछ वैल्यूज प्रिडिक्ट करके देता है. उन उन वैल्यूज को हम किस में स्टोर करा रहे हैं? जस्ट y अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट. राइट हमें पता है कि x ट्रेन के करस्पॉन्डिंग y ट्रेन क्या है. बट अभी आपको ये ध्यान नहीं रखना कि y ट्रेन क्या है. आपका जो आउटपुट मशीन जो आउटपुट दे रहा है y अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट, इस x ट्रेन के करस्पॉन्डिंग ये y ट्रेन प्रिडिक्ट आउटपुट में दे रहा है. ओके कोई भी डाउट हो तो आप लोग प्लीज पूछ लेना. अब हमने क्या किया, एक्स अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन को पास करा दिया इस मॉडल में, ये प्रिडिक्ट होकर आ गया। सिमिलरली एक्स अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट को पास करोगे तो आपको पता है क्या होना चाहिए, एक्स अंडरस्कोर वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट, राइट। हमें पता है एक्स अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट पे आउटपुट क्या आना है, वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट, बट आ जो रहा है उसको हमने नाम क्या दिया है, वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट, राइट। ये हमारे पास आउटपुट आ गया। अब आप लोग देख सकते हो, आपको पता था वाई अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन आना चाहिए, लेकिन आ क्या रहा, वाई अंडरस्कोर ट्रेन अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट वेरिएबल में। आप इन दोनों को कंपेयर करके इसके एरर निकाल सकते हो। अब जैसे यहाँ पे इसको दिखाया है, पीडी डॉट डेटा फ्रेम वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट कॉमा वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट, प्रिडिक्ट आ रहा है, आना क्या चाहिए था, टेस्ट। इन दोनों को हम प्रिंट करके देख रहे हैं कंपैरेटिवली। सो बेसिकली प्रिडिक्ट होकर जो आया है वो ये है और जो आना था वो ये है, ठीक है। 37.46 आना था, आया 37.6 है। 31.39 आना था, आया 27.9 है। इस तरह से ये आपका एक्चुअल वैल्यू है, ये आपका प्रेडिक्टेड वैल्यू है। ओके। ओके गाइस, सो पैरेलली मैंने यहाँ पे रिजल्ट्स प्रिंट करे हैं प्रिडिक्शन के और एक्चुअल के, ठीक है। अब हम क्या करेंगे, अब हम इससे एरर निकालेंगे। मीन स्क्वायर एरर, बेसिकली मीन स्क्वायर एरर होती है जिसमें हम दोनों का डिफरेंस निकाल के स्क्वायर करते हैं और उसका सम करते हैं, सम करके टोटल से डिवाइड करते हैं। सिंपल, इसमें फंक्शन होता है हमारे पास जो हमने इंपोर्ट किया। कहाँ पर इंपोर्ट किया, बेसिकली आप लोग ऊपर देखेंगे जो मैंने फर्स्ट ब्लॉक किया था उसमें मैंने मैट्रिक्सेस के अंदर एसक्यूएलएन डॉट मैट्रिक्सेस इंपोर्ट मीन अंडरस्कोर स्क्वायर्ड अंडरस्कोर एरर, इस फंक्शन को मैंने यूज किया है। ओके। अब यहाँ पे मैं मीन स्क्वायर एरर निकाल रही हूँ। मीन अंडरस्कोर स्क्वायर अंडरस्कोर एरर ब्रैकेट, किससे एरर निकाल रहे हैं, जो हमने टेस्टिंग डेटा किया है। हम लोग टेस्ट करते हैं ना, जब हमारा मॉडल प्रिपेयर हो गया ट्रेनिंग से, तो अब हम टेस्ट करेंगे कि हमारा क्या आउटपुट आ रहा है और क्या आना चाहिए। सो वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट एंड वाई अंडरस्कोर टेस्ट अंडरस्कोर प्रिडिक्ट, ये दोनों चीजें हमने यहाँ पे लिखी हैं। एंड इन दोनों से एरर निकलती है, वो किस वेरिएबल में सेव हो गई, एमएससी, एंड इट इज द 28.54। बेसिकली ये 100 में से एरर नहीं है, ये एक्चुअली एरर ऐसे होती है, लाइक यहाँ पे मैं आपको बताती हूँ, लाइक 37.6 है, 37.6 माइनस 37.4 इसका होल स्क्वायर, प्लस 27 माइनस 31 इसका होल स्क्वायर, प्लस 22 माइनस 27 इसका होल स्क्वायर, प्लस 13.8 माइनस 6.4 का होल स्क्वायर प्लस 35 माइनस 33 का होल स्क्वायर, इन सब का सम करने के बाद कितने से डिवाइड करेंगे, जितना हमारा टेस्टिंग का डेटा होगा। यहाँ पे तो अपन ने हेड ही प्रिंट किया है, टोटल टेस्टिंग का डेटा शायद 167 कुछ ऐसे था, तो डिवाइड बाई 167, ये ऑटोमेटिकली फॉर्मूला कर देगा, आपको करने की जरूरत नहीं है। एक्चुअली आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग व्हाट द फॉर्मूला विल डू, बेसिकली दिस विल कम, दिस विल टेक द डिफरेंस ऑफ बोथ एंड देन द स्क्वायर ऑफ देम डिफरेंस, देन स्क्वायर ऑफ द डिफरेंस एंड सम ऑफ ऑल द स्क्वायर डिफरेंस एंड डिवाइड बाई टोटल नंबर ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स इन साइड द टेस्ट। सो आर मीन स्क्वायर एरर हियर इज 28.54। ओके ओके गाइस, दिस इज एक्चुअली हाउ वी आर डूइंग द सिंपल मॉडल, हाउ वी आर क्रिएटिंग अ मॉडल एंड देन हाउ वी विल प्रिडिक्ट द वैल्यूज फ्रॉम द मॉडल। अब आप यहाँ पे कोई भी वैल्यू पास करवा सकते हैं, लाइक प्रिडिक्ट फंक्शन के अंदर lm डॉट प्रिडिक्ट, एंड जैसे आपका टेस्ट का डेटा है इसी तरह आप 13 कॉलम्स का एक डेटा, लाइक आप 13 फीचर्स उसको दोगे तो वो आपको आउटपुट दे देगा एक वेरिएबल में। गॉट इट? ओके गाइस, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द लीनियर रिग्रेशन। अभी तक हमने सिंपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन को समझा है, इसके बाद हम ग्राफ्स देखेंगे इसके, किसका ग्राफ हम कैसे बनाएं। सो टेल मी गाइस, टेल दिस, डिड यू गेट एवरीथिंग, और इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी नाउ, आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर योर रिस्पॉन्सेस। ओके, तान्या इज राइटिंग, नो डाउट एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर मैम, पारम इज ऑल्सो नो डाउट एंड पारम इज रिटन, बट वी शुड फर्स्ट ट्राई इट, या आफ्टर द क्लास यू गाइज प्लीज ट्राई दिस एग्जाम्पल, ओके, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल विथ मी यू कैन डू, बिकॉज इट विल टेक सो मच टाइम, सो आफ्टर द क्लास यू गाइज ट्राई इट। ओके, सो I just now tell you about the graph, how to draw a graph. Okay. Like visualization of true price and predicted price. Okay. Here we are plotting a graph. I think in the matplotlib I have shown one graph called scatter graph, okay, or either you have tried that scatter graph. What a scatter graph will do, scatter graph will plot the points, like plt, and just import matplotlib from the matplotlib, import pyplot as plt, okay, and then plt dot scatter is a function that will draw the points, simply it will draw the points, right? So plt dot scatter plot, simple, I'm just plotting a simple graph, this, plt dot scatter. Here you can see guys y underscore train, okay, and y underscore train underscore predict, like जब आप कोई पॉइंट ड्रॉ करते हो तो एक आपको x चाहिए होता है, एक y चाहिए होता है, so x एक्सिस में मैंने क्या लिया, y train, y एक्सिस में क्या लिया है, जो वैल्यू y की जो एक्चुअल वैल्यू थी उस पे प्रिडिक्टेड की क्या वैल्यू आ रही है, ठीक है, c इज इक्वल टू ब्लू, ब्लू कलर होगा and marker is O and label is training data. Here simply plt dot show. You can see the blue points. Here all the training data in which, okay, y underscore train, and then y underscore train underscore predict. This is the simple one point y underscore train like this, and the actual value should be like there is, it is near to the 5, and predicted value is also near to 5. So simply each and every point, like this one is not correct, like actual value is around the 15, but the real value is around the 5. Okay, so we have plotted all the points from the training data that have some actual value, and this x-axis having the actual value and y-axis having the predicted value. Okay, so I'm going to write here plt dot x label. Okay, or I can say it is a true value, and plt dot y label I can say predicted value. Okay, I got a question, I'm just check it. Just wait, Param, I'm coming to your question. First understand the graph, then I'll come to your question. Okay, this is the simple plot I have plotted in y underscore train and y underscore train predict. Now come to this. Here I have also plotted one graph that is called the plt y underscore test. Okay, we have some data inside the test, we have some data inside the train. So simply we are plotting one more plot. Okay, here you can see we have some testing data, and we have also plotted the testing data, and we can also give the title plt dot title. What title I have provided? True value versus predicted value, legend. Okay, so you can see here this is the legend, and this is the true value versus the predicted value is a title. Okay guys, now see this graph and I'll come to your questions. Okay, guys, am I audible now? Okay. I think there was some issue with my mic, so I have just fixed it. Okay. So this is all about the algorithm, and now you can ask me question whatever you have regarding this. And like you want to change this, like this is depends upon. I got a question from Param, like how can we minimize the error? Basically, here we need to change the values from like training. We need to change the values in the training and testing, and accordingly we will check the error. Okay, so you can change the values of this testing and training data sets, and on the different data sets you can check it, the different error will come. And further after this, in the like there are the lots of concepts like gradient descent we can use to minimize the errors, but still here you do not know the concepts of those. So here you just in the simple regression you just need to change the data sets only. Supriyansi is asking one question, ma'am. In Boston, we can design user-defined program. I'm not getting your question. You are just telling like we can design user-defined program. Basically, this is the user-defined program only. Like we are creating our program, we are just using the load underscore Boston data set. Okay. So guys, just practice this after the class, and then again in the next class you can ask me any question when you will face during implementation of this. Okay, now I'm coming to the next thing. Like this is the simple example of linear regression. You can implement over the different data set. Like we have here the data set, you can try over this. Like for the regression, there are the data set of load underscore diabetes. Same thing you can apply with the load underscore diabetes data set also, and you can check how to work it. Okay. Basically, in the equation of line y is equal to mx plus c, here we simply use the x and y. And like use of m and c is basically to minimize the error. Like we need to change the values of m and c. So that is automatically linear regression doing. You do not need to worry about that. It basically changes the values of M and C according to your data set. Okay, so just read this, and Salvi need to do one more topic. Like today is 27th, 28th, sorry. So we left only 2-3 classes, so I'll just going to the content. Okay, so we need to cover these 2-3 things, and we need to cover these. I think classes and objects we covered. Have you studied this? Today I'll tell you about the little bit about the Python exception handling. Basically, what is the Python exception handling? So that the parallelly we are also completing our Python module. So basically, exception handling, I think you know in the C++ or Java in any language, I think you have studied. Basically, in the exception handling, what is the error handling or exception handling? There is a certain situation in which our logic will not work. Okay, so we need to avoid those situations. Like in Python, when we execute a program, sometimes Python gives error. Here we learn how to handle these types of errors in Python. One is the syntax error, and another one is syntax error, and another one is a logical error, right? So exception is an error basically which occurs during the time of execution. Okay, logical error always occurs during the time of execution when program disrupts the normal flow of the program's instructions, right? Exception is a base class for all the exceptions in the Python. Basically, exception is a class, and there are the different types of exception available in the Python, right? So we need to a little bit we need to know about the exception class. Like exception class is a root class, and there is the syntax error, type error, zero division error when you try to divide by the zero, IO error, input output error, and index error, indentation error, memory error. All these kind of errors we get. Okay, so basically in Python, how to handle these exceptions? To handling these exceptions, we have try except. Here we have try and except. We need to write two blocks, try or except, to handle the exception. The try block tests the statement of the error, and except block handle the error. This is the simply try and catch in the Java. Here we have try except. In the try, we test the code, we test the statements of the error, and in the except, it handle the error. Okay, a single try statement have multiple except statements. This is useful when try block contains statements that may throw different type of exception. बेसिकली आपके पास एक ट्राई ब्लॉक है जिसमें एरर अक्कर हो सकती है, एक्सेप्शन अक्कर हो सकता है. जब वो एक्सेप्शन अक्कर होएगा तो उसको आप कहाँ हैंडल करेंगे? एक्सेप्ट ब्लॉक के अंदर, राइट? सो हियर यू कैन सी वी हैव वन ट्राई ब्लॉक, ट्राई कॉलन, ओके, ट्राई, एंड देन वी हैव सम रन फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम्स स्टेटमेंट्स. And then we have the except and then colon and the code inside the except. And else, if try block succeeds, it will execute and finally is always executed. You can see here the simple example we have taken. Like we have an array is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5 comma 6. Okay, simply we can say here I'm interchangeably uses the term array and list. These are the both are almost same in the Python. Okay, try print the third element. Simply I can print the throw error since there are only the six elements in the array. If I'm trying to access array of 7 because my index have 0 to 5, so if I'm trying to access element at seventh position, then what will happen? It will throw some exception, and exception in the except block, I have written the type of exception, index error, and it will handle my exception. When this exception occurs here, my cursor will check except block. Here is the except block, and it will check the type of exception and then print the message accordingly. Okay, so third element, it will print the three value, and then error occurred. Like this element, this print, it will not have happen, and except will handle it, and it will print the an error code. Okay, guys, you are getting? Similarly, we have try, except, and else block. This is the simple try, except. Now we have try, except, and else. Like simple try block, then except block, and then the else block. So in the try block, we have taken two user input, and C is equal to A divided by B, print C. Simply, if you are giving this normal values like A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, then it will execute and there will be no exception. Okay, and it will print nothing wrong. And if we will provide the values like a is 4 and b is 0, then a divided by b c is equal to infinity, right? So the exception occur here, and it will take the except block, and the zero division error is available. So it will go inside it and print can't divide by 0, right? So basically the exception can be raised by using the raise clause in the Python. This statement allows the programmers to force a specific exception to occur. In the raise statement, we need to define exception class. Like this is the simple try except else block. Like agar aapka exception occur hoga, to except execute hoga, otherwise else execute ho jayega. And this is the raising the exception. आप खुद रेज करना है एक्सेप्शन, तो हमें क्या करना है? सो हमारे पास एक एक्स्ट्रा ब्लॉक होगा रेज, राइट? एक रेज स्टेटमेंट होगा हमारे पास. लाइक हम चाहते हैं कि हम एक सर्टन कैटेगरी के लोगों के एंटर करवाना चाह रहे हैं. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यूजर इनपुट एज एज ए यूजर इनपुट, एंड इफ एज इज लेस देन 18 देन इट विल रेज ए वैल्यू एरर. Else age is valid, and in the value error age is not valid, it will print the message. Okay, so when I enter the age like 7, 8, 9, 10, so it will take the user input, it will take this is true, and then it will read value error, it goes inside this except and print age is not valid. Okay guys, try and finally will always execute. Okay, so this is the simple exception handling. You can read it in more detail, right? We have just we tried to provide you the concept, and you can implement in your programs, the simple programs. Okay guys, so this is about the exception handling and the a linear regression implementation. Okay, I think enough for today. What happened, guys? Please give me a response. Yes. Yes, tell me, Supriyanshi. Supriyansi is asking a question, ma'am. Anaconda is run on the internet. No, Supriyansi, Anaconda is running in a like any browser. It do not need internet. Priya is asking for the ma'am, what is the fees of advanced Python summer training? Actually, after this batch, we are going to start a batch from the 1st of May, that is advance of this machine learning and the Python part. Basically, in that, we are going to cover the deep learning, computer vision, image processing part, and OpenCV part. So, fees of that batch is 3000 only. Okay. And Supriyansi is asking one more question. Okay, this one is asked by the Priya Chaudhary. So Priyansi is asking one question. Ma'am, yesterday I am downloading the Anaconda, but faced there so much problem. You simply download the Anaconda and then install it. You can watch my video on the YouTube also, how to install the Anaconda. And Devansh is asking, ma'am, I have read exception handling yesterday only and have written summary yesterday itself. So do I need to write it again? No, Devansh, don't need it. If you have written, then that is good. Okay. Okay, guys. Thank you all.